Hello and welcome. Today I would like to present you the latest invention from Ladybug Turks under the Spider team, which is the GBXML viewer. I am very big fan of GBXML format because it can give us lots of incredible capability, and so far is the most common format that we can use for the energy models. And today I would like to present you the first and early develop functionality of the GBXML viewer. So if you go to the Ladybug Tools Spider GBXML viewer, today is the latest version 10.3, but I think almost every day or every couple of days there is a new edition, so just please watch out for the latest version. And here what we have is this kind of great interface for the viewer with the lots of capability, and today I would like to talk through some of them. So when you load the page, you have a sample file, and what we can do, we can switch the dot rotation, we can switch on and off surfaces and edges, so we have full control over the visual site. We can reset the view that will bring us to the initial screen. Now on left-hand side we can load our own file. So if you want to test the file you just produce from Revit, and you want to check how many warnings error, or you would like to do some fixes, this is the place to do. This is the most neat, fastest and quick viewer you can find so far, and it's open source, part of the Ladybug family, which means it's great. Okay, so here are the main feature. So we have a heads-up display. What it does when you click, you can go to any surface and you can see all the data that relates to the surface. So here we can see the ID of the surface. It belongs to the roof group, belongs to the basic roof, and we can switch it off and on the visibility. We can check to which zone it belongs to which story. So this is really like amazing. I think that we can very quickly go through from the surface what was made in Revit. So we know in Revit this was as a whole roof, but obviously GBXML export split it into two surfaces, so we can all see it there. The next one is the settings. Settings are used for the visual purpose. So if I just reset view to come back to the original setup, we can toggle through again through surfaces, edges, and all, and we can here choose the different colors. So we can see the normal, our default, and what I really like, the exposure type. Those are very cool because we can very quickly see if there are some issue with the model. So here we can see this kind of yellowish, which is the shade. So we cannot see them in the building, which is so far so good. All the green one are exposed to outside, and red one are like the interior. And then we have ground surfaces. So we can see very quickly by the colors if everything seems to be fine. And then we can switch off the shadows and change the background, wireframe, and check the normals for the surfaces. So we have quite cool control over what we see. Obviously, we can switch it on and off. The next one is the report. So here we can see more stuff about the GBXML, like which campus it belongs, which location, and if this was specified in Revit, will go us to the Google Maps. We can also see the building, story. And here we can just check the building by story. I really like to always switch off the edges, and we can really now check if everything is fine with the building. Okay. And then we can see the spaces. We can see area and just check if anything is fine or there are some kind of odd one out situations. We can also check tiny spaces, so those are the spaces less than 2 square meter. So here I can see this, the rise is 1.4 square meters, so you can see if there are not some unwanted spaces. Then we can see the zones. In this model we don't have the zones, only the spaces. and then surfaces. So we can check within the model, I'll just reset this view, only the interior walls, interior floors, external walls, slab on grade, ceilings if we have any, roof, slab, and so on, and shades. We would see also here air or some other problematic. They also show in number of surfaces and some kind of percentage. We can switch it off, I think, back. And here we can check the errors. Duplicate coordinates, we don't have any. Duplicate cut object, and I think we have quite a few. What it is, in Revit we could have, let me show you the example. In Revit this wall is drawn as one wall, but the GBXML will divide this wall into two different walls. That's why you can see here the our main wall is a basic wall internal solid core and have the element ID from Revit. However, later on GBXML is splitting this one. That's why we have like one element ID for the two surfaces of the same wall, because it's the way how GBXML export works from Revit. Okay, and here we can see duplicate latency, and this is one which we'd like to solve today. So what it is, we can see here, when we click on our heads-up display, we can see the, let me just switch it off. Yeah. So we can see that we have the surface, which is internal wall, but we have the same zone on both sides, which is not normal. Because if we come back to, if I reset the view, normally we should have two different surfaces on both sides of the internal surfaces, and this is correct. And if this is not like this, this means that we have the air ceiling or some problematic surface which would cause the issue in the simulation tool, and that's why we need to somehow fix those surfaces. My favorite way of fixing this, so here we can see we have 8 of them. This one is area 4.9, this one is 0, you see. So this is the very, very tiny stripe that belongs to this floor, and is 1.6 meter long by 0.002. So it's so tiny that I would usually, normally I'm ignoring those ones. So 0, 0, 0, 0. The here is the 5, so I think this we should look, and this one, and this one. All other one we can ignore. There's also the surfaces with a very tiny area, so you can see if they causing some kind of issue, to which wall they belong and to which space. And we can also just to see if there is anything which we would like to fix. So let me just show today how we can fix those common problems with duplicate surfaces. So I usually like to go to this main view, which is in settings, and I like to go to the exposure. And then my favorite way is just to go through the stories, so I can see all this kind of abnormality. I will close this for a second, so we can see the level 0, everything seems to be fine. You will see something, some weird colors. Level B1, everything seems to be fine. Level 1, here we can see those colors. Yeah, so we can see straight away that we have the blue colors, so all everything looks fine apart from those two. And now we can just have a play. So you can see this one is interior wall. I have two different surfaces on both sides. But if you click this one, we have coffee shop, and I will hide this one. And behind this is the second lift. I make again all visible. I think this gonna be improve a lot the user friendliness of this, but today I'm just to show you what we can do with this tool. Okay, so what I'm gonna do today is I will just try to fix it. So I know we have space 2973, and I will try to fix it. So we have the first one 2973. I will delete this one, and this one 2973 we're gonna apply. So we're gonna go to edit, and we're gonna add 2973. 2973. So what I'm doing now, I'm just changing in GPXML the way how the wall is structured. So we deleted one wall, and we're gonna now update the surface of the second wall. So we're gonna go again to our stories, where level one. So you see, when we put the second time, the first one is already fixed. So if I click wall, it's only one, and now is the time to fix the second one. So we have in front 2449. I'll just delete this one. And the second one we're gonna fix 2449. And I'll just update surface. So now we should see in story, everything should be fine now on level 01. Yeah, so when I click this, we have two different surfaces connected. And once we fix GPXML, we can actually download the file. So I can go here, we can add who modify, and we can just save edit. What it does is downloading the file. So let me just open this file, and I'll just place this file, and we're gonna just start again. So I'll refresh the screen, and we're just gonna upload this this new file. Okay, and if we're gonna go to the report. You see, under duplicate adjacency, we don't have these big surfaces. We have only this tiny one with 0, 0, 0, 0. And now we can try to import the those two XML to our simulation tool. So again, I will come back to the original screen just to have the initial model downloaded as well. So we can go to the edit and just download the model however it was created. Just copy this. Okay, so we have 11 not fixed and 10 fixed, and I'll try to import them into two tools. So here is the task. So let's try to import. Okay, we're gonna get first the broken one. Okay, I'm just importing this. And here we can see that we have the unknown adjacency. See, those are those two surfaces that we have problem with, which means they are adiabatic because it's the same surface on both sides, which means there will be no heat transfer between them. And now let me just import the second file. Okay, as you can see, here we don't have this error with the surface. We have some other warning, but those are easy to fix. All we have to do, we have to just reverse the incorrect orientation, and most of them will be fixed. But we don't have at the moment this kind of issue with this adiabatic. There's only some problem with the gaps, but we can ignore them because usually those are this kind of tiny gaps around. But those surfaces on level one are correctly recognized, and they are correctly linked. Okay, thank you very much. I hope you like this tool and I hope it will help you to make your model perfect. Thank you very much.